Transaction set maintenance is used to enter parameters against the individual transactions. The administrator selects the transaction which needs to have the parameters looked at. So for instance, if we look at report production, these are all the parameters that the administrator is able to change. Some of these are Booleans, which just require yes and no. Some are text, which will require entry. And some of these are group parameters, as we've seen before. When the parameters have been changed, the administrator should save them. Some transactions have parameters at the transaction level and at order type level. So for instance, if we look at the receiving transaction, then we can see there we have only a single parameter at the transaction level, and then we have multiple parameters at the order type level. This allows us to have different parameter settings for different types of orders. So for instance, for purchase orders, we might want to do a filter by warehouse, but for other types of orders, we might not want to do that filter. Or we might want to allow the inspection flag to be entered for purchase or purchase manual, but not for sales returns. If we wish to store some parameters at an order type level, we select the order type and then select the type that we wish to change. So if I want to say for sales, we're going to have specific order types, and that just means I've copied them from the generic order type level to the sales order type level, and now I can go and change them so that for the sales, I'm not going to have a filter by warehouse, or I'm not going to allow inspection flag to be set. If we look at the order type parameters, then they are still set as they were for every other type of order, but for sales, we have a specific set of parameters which I can see. And if I want to, I can deselect it, which will allow me to remove those parameters from the particular order type. So now sales will default back to the standard method. We can also at this point decide which of these order types are enabled and which are disabled in a particular configuration. If people don't use ASC production and customer claims and EP distribution and maintenance sales, then we should deselect these from here. This just means that now if I go in and start a receipts transaction, so if I go into the LN menu and just start at the receipts transaction and select the order types that I can select from, then those will be reduced accordingly. So I don't see my ASC and so on and so forth. All of those have been removed because I've said that in our environment, we just don't deal with them. So this is the purpose of the order types and order type parameters. The order types are for two purposes: to allow specific parameters to be saved against one particular order type, but also to disable those order types from showing up for the operator.